everyone. I have recently received so many inquiries from artists about online art platforms that I decided to do a separate video about it. But before I start answering your questions, please let me know if you are already selling art online and whether you had success with it. Please type your answer in the comments. You may have already read my blog post where I wrote about online art sales platforms, and in fact, I have calculated 37 places where you can sell art online. That's quite a lot, isn't it? So you might be wondering how to choose the one that is right for you. Well, this number 37 platforms consists of different types of websites where you can sell art. First of all, there are platforms that are specialized in selling art, like Saatchi Art, probably the most well-known of them, or Art Finder. But there are many, many more, larger, smaller ones. There are also general e-commerce sites like Amazon or Etsy. There are print-to-order services where you can sell prints or put your arts on mugs, pillows, blankets, whatever. And also some hybrid websites where you can promote your art or use some kind of online services and also use it as a channel to sell your art. If you don't have my list yet, please check the comments and you will find a link where you can download a PDF and check out my article about all these websites where you can sell your art. Now I will discuss a little bit more in depth how to choose which one is right for you. Well, there are several tips, and first of all, what you need to consider is choosing several art platforms, because you will need to be more than on one art sales platform. And there are several reasons for it. First of all, you might want to test different types of art e-commerce websites. Second reason is that art sales platforms come and go, just as, you know, applications. This market is very competitive, and we all observed, you know, that Skype was very popular at one time, and now maybe WhatsApp or Viber have taken over. Similar things may happen with online art platforms. I'm seeing new art platforms, new concepts being developed. There are new startups coming in, but not all of them will probably be successful. So I would recommend choosing two or three, and maybe choose a platform that is already well established and also a startup, because you never know what will skyrocket. And actually, if you choose a platform in its early stage and you are consistent with uploading your works and promoting yourself there, you will grow as this platform grows. So I think it's all about trying things out, experimenting, being brave, and just checking what's new on the market. Also, before you start selling online, there are several things you need to do. I have spoke about it in my previous video, and if you haven't seen it yet, please check it out, just to make sure that you are well prepared to sell art online, because it requires a certain consistency, and internet likes things that are done on a regular basis. Okay, let's move to the second criteria when choosing the art platform where to sell your work. And of course, what you need to consider is the medium. Will it be original paintings? Maybe it will be prints. Maybe you would want to sell a digital art, digital downloads. All these mediums are requiring a bit different platforms, research platforms. Check if they do sell what you want to sell, check the competition, and think how you will stand out. Because paintings, of course, is the most competitive medium. And if you are a painter, you will definitely need to be creative and work really hard to compete with those who are established online and have a strong presence on the internet. The third thing you need to check is investigate what is the audience of the platform you are choosing. First of all, in terms of the size, I use a tool called SimilarWeb, and you can check how many people visit certain website during the month, if the flow of visitors is rising or decreasing, so you can more get the idea if this platform is right for you in terms of the size of the audience and the countries where these people are coming from. Of course, most online buyers, at least from what I saw, come from United States or United Kingdom. These are, of course, the largest markets, but there are also smaller markets like France that are growing online. And you must think if your artworks match kind of the culture and tastes of the peoples who live there and who visit these certain platforms. You should also check the price ranges and investigate what sells in the certain platform. For example, if you choose to sell on Etsy, you probably are aware that the average price of the pieces sold on Etsy is quite low. It can be around $20 or $30 on average. But if you check what sells on Saatchi Art, you will realize that it is more expensive works. Prices may range from $500 to $1,000 and $2,000 and even to $5,000 and more, depending of course on the medium, the size of the artwork and how well established the artist is. So when you have decided on the prices of your artworks, just monitor few platforms for a certain period of time. Most of them have some sections where you can see what kind of pieces were sold recently, and just check whether the art that sells there is in a similar price range as yours. And the interesting thing, what I have personally realized, that lower price doesn't always guarantee success. But of course, it depends on a lot of factors, and I will probably expand on this in my later videos. So make sure you are subscribed to my channel and follow the news. The other thing you need to be aware of is costs. Although joining art sales platform is free, but most of them have various costs and it differs from platform to platform. So you should consider things like commission. If you join for free, you will probably have to pay commission. Some platforms have introduced a fixed monthly fee, and you may have to pay to be able to access some premium features. Then the shipping costs. If you sell from one platform, you probably will have to ship and pay for shipping yourself. If you sell with other platforms, let's say Saatchi Art does everything for you. Also, you must read carefully what is the shipping and returns policy, and know when you will get the money after the sale is completed, because you will not be paid straight just when the sale was made. Usually it can take from 2 to 4 weeks until you receive a payout. So please read all the policies and know how the platform you are choosing is operating. And the last tip is be consistent, be patient, experiment, and be creative. You already have it. If you are an artist, you will need to use your creativity and think how to stand out, how to make your artworks look attractive, and how to use this minute or maybe even less to convince a person to buy your artwork. If you found this video useful, please like and share and support my mission in helping artists to sell more art. Don't forget to subscribe because I am uploading new videos on a regular basis. And if you have any questions or would like me to explore some topic in more detail, please leave a comment.